All right, we're on our way to our next service call at the Inwood Country Club. The Inwood Country Club, private, members and guests only.
I'll show you my privates.
We're checking out an AO Smith water heater that's got some issues. We're here for AO Smith and another contractor. Let's go see what's going on. Are those, what do you call, plantation pillars?
They're pretty close.
They are, right?
Destination is on your right.
Am I going to fit under this thing? Yeah, for sure, right?
Yeah, you'll fit under.
Deliveries. We'll go this way.
Past it and then take a left, you said?
Just past it and then find, see by the garages. He said he's outside. Let's go find him. Let's see where we should park. Of course, I'm handicapped. I took both handicap spots. I'm real special. I'm real special. I took both spots. How you doing? I'm Mike.
Mike,
you got an AO Smith water heater, right? Problems with it?
Yeah.
Yeah, lead the way. Let's see what's going on. Here for a second opinion. So, let's see what's going on with this thing. I hear you. Been having problems, huh?
Yeah.
And that, what's a brand new water heater too?
Brand new.
Brand new is like a few days, few months, what, a few weeks?
Well, a few weeks.
A few weeks.
Okay.
It smells good in here though. It smells like.
There's the one here right here.
This is the one here?
Yep.
You have two of these, right? There's one. Why is there not a... Oh, there's a draft hood. And this goes into there. Now, you have another water heater like this, right? Where's that? You have two of them, or it's one?
No, there's one.
I thought you had another water heater.
No, here's that.
Really?
Yeah.
I was told you have two water heaters.
No, two gas valves. Does it?
No, no, no. Don't you have another water heater here too?
No, no, only that one. This is the storage tank.
Ah, that's the storage tank, yeah. For?
For that water heater.
Okay. So what happens when you turn this thing on? Oh, this is the one with the rollout.
Right. So the flame comes out. This is... This came with the original water heater.
Okay.
That's a replacement.
And it still does the same thing.
Okay, you got the Honeywell dual gas valves for 500,000 BTUs. BTR-500-130. There's a good flame roll out there too. We gotta take a gas pressure reading here. The gas is off. Okay. You know where the manometer is? Oh, get the tool bag. Yep.
When you put the new valve, do the same trick.
All right, let's see. Chris, get ready for that switch and get ready for this. Apparently, the gas shoots out about a foot.
About a foot?
About a foot. Oh.
Yeah.
Like that, yeah. Yep.
That's only a start.
Yep. Try to switch off. Huh? Let's try to get a better view. All right, Chris, turn that thing back on. Got plenty of exhaust coming out, right? We're gonna do a quick little test. See if our exhaust is blocked. I have ignition. Yeah. Yeah, no good. All right, kill it. We don't want to kill the occupants of the country club. So we have, and it's still going too, but look at this. It's still going. Power's off. If I turn the gas off, it stops. See that?
Unknown caller.
Wow. All right, we're on hold here. Smith. Let's hook up our digital manometer to the first valve and take a pressure reading. 7.131415 climbing. No, okay.
Thank you for calling technical support.
Hi, how are you? Can you hear me? Are you able to?
All right, it looks like we issued an L number and gave some certified service provider information.
So I'm your authorized service provider.
Okay. All right.
I didn't get the L number, but I'm going to need that. So I verified, we do have flame rollout during ignition, and with the power off, we have flame. We still have flame. We have gas pressure leaving the gas valve. Unless you actually turn the gas off, the gas stops burning at the combustion chamber.
But with the power to the unit off, you still have flame.
Correct.
Do you know what the gas pressure there is?
Yep, 7.3 inches of water column. Now, I've been made aware that the gas valve has already been replaced from your stock.
And then, like, if you got the power off, the gas off, and you turn the gas back on, does it just leak gas?
No, I haven't turned the gas. I haven't tried that, but right now my gas valve is on. Sorry, my gas cock is on, and that's how I'm reading pressure of 7.3 inches of water column, but I do not smell gas if I reopen it. I haven't tried that, though. Would you like me to try that?
Yes, sir.
All right. So, Chris, let's fire this thing back up. It's already on. The power. All right, I'm going to stand. Let me move my hose for the pressure tubing.
Good.
And listen, worst case scenario, you have to get ready to kill the gas. All right, I'll stand in front of it. Go ahead. I smell gas, but I don't have ignition.
Do we need
no
power?
Do you have any
ghosts
today? I don't know. Why don't we have ignition yet? Alright, we have ignition.
No power then.
Hold on. So right now we don't have the rollout condition like we did before. She's burning properly. No. Nope. All right, turn the power off. And now she worked. Oh, no, I have flame. I have flame. Hold on. I have gas, ignited gas leaving my main burners under the water heater.
What the hell was that? It sounded like something was sizzling.
All right, as you can see, power is off. Now, I had 7.17 inches of water column. Both valves are in the on position on the gas controls. Let's turn both of them off and then they stop. Yeah? Let's turn them back on. And it reignites. It reignites. Wow. And I got this all on video, guy. So right now, power's off to the water heater. I have flame coming from my combustion burners. And right now I'm at 7.04 inches of water column. I'm gonna turn the gas control valve, the black dial, to the off position. And I do one, and then I do the other. The flame is slowing down. The flame is now gone. And I'm at 7.3 inches of water column. I'm gonna turn them both back on. And I still have gas passing through. So now let's try disconnecting the wiring. I've disconnected the wiring, those three, the blue, red, and the white wire, and I'm still, it just stopped now. We have something really, really funky going on here, now, AO Smith.
You hear your exhaust
back on? Yep. A strong, you know, a sense of carbon burning, you know, that soot smell. And I have flame rollout. I have the bottom of my jacket is charred from the rollout. Some of the wiring is also burnt up, going to the, looks like the igniter. Let's do this cyclist again. Let's turn the power back on and let's see what happens. So the inducer assembly is running, the blower is running. My gas is both on. Let's see what happens. So I have main ignition. I do not appear to have flame rollout right now. Looks good. But I did have a sudden, you know, I did have a little bit of flame rollout during ignition, during initial combustion, during initial ignition. Now let's turn the power off. And I have flame. Let's see if maybe it's residual gas. It's burning off. We already know it's not true because if I close the gas valves or the gas cock, it stops immediately. All right? Yeah. It's been 20 seconds. The gas is still flowing and it's burning. All right, let's turn that gas valve off on top. Okay, and immediately it stops. A little bit of residual there, it's going away right now. Let's open that back up, and it reignites.
You ready? I'm gonna do 3, 2, and 1.
Hold on, waiting for the last flame to go away. Still there, almost gone. It's gone, reopen.
I can hear it though.
I can hear it. And it reignited. Look at that. We have power off to the water heater, and I have ignition on inside the combustion chamber from gas escaping the gas valves with 7 point. All right, now, where did it go? All right now, the gas is off, so yeah. That's why we don't have any gas flowing through there. So you heard the conversation. AO Smith wants the old water heater back. They gave me authorization for today's labor. They gave an authorization, which I'll give to the original installing contractor for a warranty replacement of the entire tank. Now, the procedure is they have to reach out to the original distributor for this product, wherever it came from. They have to acquire the new one. Whatever fees are involved, it's all borne on the whoever. It's not AO Smith, whatever. It's disabled. The gas is off. I disconnected the power. I turned off both gas valves there. Do not run it. It is a huge liability, and you'll burn down the building.
It hasn't been running since.
Good.
Good. All right. Keep it that way. Hey, Mike from the Pipe Doctor.
What's going on?
So I'm just leaving the Inwood Country Club.
Okay.
For that second opinion.
Okay.
So I verified exactly what you verified.
Okay.
What's the keys where? Oh. Sorry. So you have flame rollout. I verified you have, you know, under 7.5 inches of water column with the system off. I also verified that if you turn the power off, the flame continues to come out of the main gas valves.
Perfect.
Unless you actually close the gas cock or the gas control dials on both valves. Right. I called AO Smith. You got an authorization number to replace the water heater. They want the old water heater back, by the way. They want it back to their factory.
Got it.
All right, so hopefully you had enough margin in the install where you can now do that.
I'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
No problem, sorry.
So they have it on record over there, right?
Yeah, let me get your... I have your email address. I'll email you the receipt, which has that R number or that replacement number, and you'll need that number to whoever you got this water heater from to obtain the new one and then all the associated expenses with that, so... All right,
perfect.
All right. All right, my pleasure. All right, bye. All right. We did our due diligence, and I've never seen that before. Have you ever seen that before?
Well, obviously you haven't, because you're not really an HVAC tech. Or a plumber.
But today is Wednesday, June 22nd, 2022, and today is National HVAC Technician Day. Thank you to all you guys out there for bringing comfort to our indoor confined spaces. Thank you. All right, guys, be well. God bless. I'll catch you in the next one. Stay safe.